you're interested, I'm about to tell you the most important word in the whole Bible. A number of years back, and I was in a season of particularly seeking the Lord, and what I was doing, I was devouring the words of Jesus. And in that particular season, as I'm pursuing the words of Christ, I began to notice a certain word. He said it there. He said it there. He said it there. And there. And I was like, Jesus used that word a lot. And here came the rhema. It's the most important word in the whole Bible. Here. He who has ears to hear, let him hear. How many times did he say it? In his blockbuster parable of the sower, this one heard the word this way, this one heard the word this way, this one heard the word this way, this one heard the word with a good heart. Start looking for the word here in the Bible, and it'll start popping off the page at you. This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Hear him. Somebody goes, well, actually, I don't agree with that. I think the most important word in the Bible is love. Okay. But there is a verse that goes, hear, O Israel, you shall love the Lord your God. Somebody goes, well, I don't agree with that. I think the most important word in the Bible is faith. Okay. But there is a verse that goes, faith comes by... I'm telling you, everything in the kingdom is contingent upon hearing from God. When you hear, now you can obey. When you hear, now you can believe. It all comes down to hearing. Which is why, when I go to the secret place, I don't go primarily to talk. My primary focus in the secret place is not to talk, it's to hear. Because things don't change when I talk to God. Things change when God talks to me. When I talk, in case you haven't noticed, nothing happens. When God talks, universes come into existence. Everything changes when you hear a word from God.